and the finisher of my faith. So whatever God says I got it, I got it. I don't look for nobody to tell me I'm anointed. I know God called me. I know God has anointed me. I don't look for nobody to tell me I look good. I look in the mirror and I saw how fine I was in the mirror. You gotta encourage yourself. Encourage yourself.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Because the devil, he's trying to keep your mind. Yes. In the book of Philippians, the second chapter, and the fifth verse, it says, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Look at somebody and say, get your mind right.
Get your mind right.
Get your mind right, because in the book of Philippians, it tells you what you need to think of. It says in Philippians, the fourth chapter, the seventh through the eighth verse, it says, and the peace of God, which passes all understanding, it shall keep your heart, and it shall keep your mind. Through Christ Jesus. Now it says this, finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on
these things. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So in other words, you gotta elevate your mind.
Yes. Elevate it.
Look at somebody and say, elevate your mind.
Elevate your mind.
Because I got high expectations. The devil is a liar. I got high expectations. I'm not going to be trapped by the confines of society. Hallelujah. I can have just what I want. Come on and give God praise.
Amen.
Another thing that you have to have in order to walk in the darkness, you gotta have the word of God, because the word of God says that the word is a lamp.
Uh-huh.
There goes the light. There's a lamp unto my feet.
Uh-huh. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And a light unto my pathway. So in other words, you gotta get the word down on the inside of you. You may be in a dry place right now, but you gotta put the word back on the devil and let the devil know that I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. And if I delight myself in him, he will give me the desires of my heart.
Yes, yes.
So when you're faced with discouragement, when you're in a dark place, the word of God will be your light in your dark place.
Hey!
Come on, somebody, and say, the word is going to be my light in my dark place. That's why it's very important to study the word. That's why it's very important to recite scriptures in your mind. Because sometimes, I'm going to be honest with you and transparent with you, sometimes I don't feel like moving on. Sometimes I don't feel like I'm the best person in the world.
Oh my God.
I get the word over and over in my mind.
Yes.
It gives me strength. It gives me joy. And I'm about to cut out here. But another thing that you gotta do.
Come on, preacher.
When you in your dark place, you gotta learn how to praise God in the midst of your dark place.
Yes.
I got a witness in the book of Acts. When we talk about Paul and Silas, Paul and Silas were in jail. They were in the inner prison. In other words, they were in the hole. Come on, somebody. And they were in the hole, but they began to praise God.
Well,
the Bible says that one sung praises and the other one prayed, and they began to praise God together. And the Bible says as they began to give God glory, as they began to give God praise in their dark place, the Bible says that an earthquake flew open the prison doors. Hallelujah. And God released him from their prison experience. I just stopped by perfecting the holiness to let somebody know you may be in your dark place, but God is getting ready to pull you out of your dark place. You gotta hold on and trust God.
I was in the top place.